Yeah, obviously a different ball game coming in to the night and playing into the T20. So it was just a different mindset for us just to come out there and perform to the best of our ability. I think in all three aspects of the game was really good today. So it's always good to get the first win over the line and just carry the momentum throughout the series. So obviously for us, the way we gel on and off the field, I think that has been really key for us. And it just makes it easier for the players going onto the field and just portraying their skill over there. I always say it's not a skill thing that we have, it's a mental thing. But I'm really glad the mental shift that changed towards the ODIs, towards the T20s, and it just showed tonight again that we're one of the greatest in the world. Yeah, so for us, we knew obviously we had a practice session last night where we hit our lines and our lengths. So we just had to assess which lines and ends was going to be key for us tonight. And then when I came on my first two goals, I knew that back of lane was going to be good for us. And that is just what we ran with throughout the whole innings, which is really good. And obviously the change of pace worked nicely for us as well. So just overall, it was a really good pitch to bat and to bowl. And I really enjoyed bowling on the pitch tonight. It was really good. Like we spoke about, it's just the areas we needed to assess ourselves. Like in the ODIs, you could see the figures that we came out of wasn't that great. But like I said, we had a training session last night where we needed to assess the wicket as quick as possible and then make the calls from there. And myself as a senior bowler to obviously carry the knowledge and tell the next bowler that's coming on, this is the areas we need to hit, and then just run with it. And like I said, our figures spoke for ourselves. And I think all the bowlers that came in today just took the lead, and it was really good for us. I always say it's pretty simple for me. First of all, it's how you carry your body. I mean, I'm at the age of 32 now at the moment, and I think the way I've been bowling and my career, I feel like now my career is just peaking at the moment. And I always train like every game is a final. So I think that is the most key thing for me, is obviously knowing what I need to do, acknowledging my body when it's tired, when it's not tired, obviously getting the amount of overs that I need to bowl before a game or during even practice sessions. So just for me as a senior bowler to assess what my body needs and how to carry it onto the field. For us, it's just a mental mind shift. Like obviously we came from the ODIs and just a different ball game. We know it's gonna be fiery, it's gonna be quick. So just for us to shift our mentality, knowing that, you know what, yes, we are working towards the ODI World Cup, and I think we've done really well to come out here in India and get a series win where it was 4-1. I think that's really good for the team. But then knowing what the end result is as well, so it's for us to take baby steps towards reaching that goal of getting into the World Cup and obviously not trying actually winning the World Cup. So it's always going to be a different mindset. I always speak about us having the skill, us having the ability. So just for us to go out there and display our talent. As professional cricketers, as for me myself, like I mentioned before earlier, that I train every game like it's a final. It doesn't always come off, and I mean, even the best in the world doesn't always come off like we planned it to be. But it's just showing that consistency, having that presence at the crease, and that's one thing I always strive to work on, is that having that presence, whether I'm batting, whether I'm bowling, whether I'm on the park, is always be in the batter's face or in the opposition's face, knowing that, you know what, I am on the field, I'm ready to take on the world. And whenever the captain throws me the ball, I know that, you know what, I am ready. And I'm a firm believer of it. When things doesn't go your way as a bowler, there's always that bounce back ability where you get a batter. If a batter gets a jaffa of a ball, you know that the batter's back in the dugout. Where us as bowlers, we either have 4 overs in the T20 or we got 10 overs in the ODI. So you can always bounce back on that strategy. We speak about the longer we stay at the crease, the easier it's going to get for batters. And I mean, for bowlers, it's easy. You just come in and obviously you want to hit your line, and then sometimes it works out, sometimes it doesn't work out. But like I spoke about, I know, yes, we know it's a T20, but I mean, if you're a strong, powerful leader, you know that you can always catch up at the back end. And I think the way Anika batted today was really just a display of how T20 cricket should be. I mean, she batted throughout the whole innings, which was really great to see. And then you get obviously Nazelle. Yes, she hasn't scored today, but we know that, you know what, she's one of that big hitters that we actually need in the side, that's always going to give us that, you know, that quick 30s, that quick fire of 40s, or even get us a century in the T20. So just that, having that mental mind shift of, you know what, this is T20s, but the longer we bat, the easier it's going to get for us throughout the innings.